music is really important.
I think it's critical to anyone's education.
The music program at Upper Darby, our arts programs, and all of our extracurricular things really do wonderful, wonderful things for our kids.
It's embedded in the entire district. There's not a school you can go into that doesn't have some type of art or music, particularly music, going on.
One of the things that we see in any community is the importance of really speaking into the lives of youth.
Because it's a universal language. No matter where and what people are doing in their lives, no matter what differences they have.
If they don't have that ability to feel or create, whether it's through music or whether it's through art, people need to have that outlet. My name is Jennifer Schoener, and I've been a public school music teacher for 25 years now. I teach in the Eastern Lancaster County School District. I have been a high school band director, a middle school band director, and now an elementary band and orchestra director. I did about 8 years of high school band and middle school band, and then when I met my late husband Brad, then I switched to elementary. But that's what I do full-time. Part-time, I work for the Upper Darby Arts and Education Foundation as their executive director. The foundation actually started back in 1987. Harry Dietzler was the original director. And Harry's heavily involved with Upper Darby Summer Stage, and he's the director for the Performing Arts Center there. So Harry's the one who really started everything, and long before I ever got there, they were raising, $1 million in grants for the school district. So it had already been well established. The mission for the Upper Darby Arts and Education Foundation is to provide educational opportunities that the school district cannot supply necessarily because of financial limits. And with the budget cuts in the past several years through the state, it's been a very, very difficult situation for Upper Darby. And being one of the largest school districts in Pennsylvania, they've had some severe cuts in the school district. So the foundation has been there to support the school district, and if things keep going the way they are, in the next 2 years, we'll have supplied over $2 million in grants to the district, which the board is made up of all community members, which is really, really something, I think. And they're from all different backgrounds. But all of them are very caring about that community, and they want to see it stay strong, and they want to see the arts stay strong, which is one reason I love working there, because it's a very united community.
My name is Thomas Picozzi. I'm the mayor of Upper Darby Township. I've been mayor for 5 years. Previous to being mayor, I was a 20-year council person here, and I represented the second district of Upper Darby, which is the furthest western district. I did a tour of the schools they had offered, and one of the classrooms we went to was Brad Schoener's. And in that classroom, I could see the enthusiasm of Brad shining through the children. It was in probably middle school, if I recall. It's back a ways. But one of the things I saw there was the children, the group that was there, was probably not from the more fluent section of the township, but they had saxophones, they had flutes, and the amazing part was they're actually performing. So it wasn't like we were practicing. We were probably in the springtime, and Brad had done a tune for him, and they were real proud to show us that. That always was in my mind.
I don't know whether it's influential or just what made him Brad. Like, anybody that met him, you would never forget him. Long black hair, always had some kind of crazy shirt on. He was like a big kid. And to me, he was kind of like a kid magnet, because honestly, wherever we went, it could be the grocery store, it could be the beach. He literally had 10 kids following him everywhere. And he just seemed to understand them and relate to them. And the fun part about him was that any adult that he talked to, he could figure out where the kid in them was, and he could bring that out very quickly. And somehow he got away with things that other adults couldn't, and I don't know how to put that into words, but that's part of what made Brad memorable. He also played with tons and tons of rhythm and blues bands, horn bands all over the East Coast. He could pick up, I've never met a person that could pick up pretty much anything and play it really, really, I mean, really well, including bagpipes, which I wasn't quite ready for that part. But the first time he did it, he would play, every year he would play for the Philly distance run. And he was the halfway mark for all of the runners. And so when you hear the piper, you knew you were halfway through the run. And he did it for 25 years. So everybody knew his spot. As a matter of fact, his kids, his students still play in his spot every September. And they've been doing that now. This will be 7 years coming up. And they still keep doing that spot for him. After Brad passed away in 2009, we started the Schoener Fund. It was actually Brad's idea. Brad had three wishes for the Schoener Fund. The first was to have instruments in the hands of every student in the Upper Darby School District who really wanted to learn to play an instrument. The second wish that Brad had was to have a scholarship available for any students who showed that they had a lot of musical talent and could move forward with the help of some extra funding. And the third wish was to have a summer music camp, and that actually turned into the Schoener MusicMan camp. And there was a small committee of five of us that had the first, we called it a music marathon instead of a music festival. And he wanted it to go 24 hours, but we thought of that, but we really, none of us really could make it that long. So we actually turned it into, it was actually a 12-hour festival the first year. And within 3 months, we had our first music marathon, which is pretty amazing, considering it takes us a year to put together now, but the first one we did in 3 months. The 5K actually came around the second year, and Gary Buss, who's the CEO of Arlington Cemetery, they're right across the street from the Upper Darby Performing Arts Center, he called me and he said, hey, we've always wanted to have a 5K in the cemetery, and we heard about what you're doing over in the school. He said, do you think maybe we could combine the two? If you go through the cemetery twice, that's the 5K. If you do the loop once, that's what the walkers do. But Arlington Cemetery has supported this every year now. And so it's just made the festival and the entire event even bigger.
Hi, my name is Matthew Carlton. I am a sixth grade math teacher at Drexel Hill Middle School and also a volleyball and baseball coach. A few years back, I got in contact with Steve Brown, who is the race director of the Brad Schoener 5K. And he asked me to help out a little bit with trying to pull some of the schools together. So when we started, we ended up with a great group of kids run by Bywood Running Club. And they just got really excited and came and ran. Teachers were with each child. It was really a great event. And we really started thinking, hey, this is really awesome. How can we get more schools to be a part? And that kind of just grew on its own to where now we have 9 schools in the district who participated as a group. A lot of them have their own t-shirts, we have their mascots there, it was really great. This year we incorporated the mascot race, which was an absolute blast, and we look forward to moving this race to encompass more of what Upper Darby is about, which is the community, which is the arts, music, and also the athletics, and this event really pulls that all together in celebration of an amazing man, Brad Schoener.
It was originally the music marathon for 6 years. This year, we decided to change it to a community music festival. The reason for that being is, originally it started off and it was just performers from within the school district. And it featured, you know, a lot of the different groups from every school. But each school would send a performing group. And then we had a lot of parents come out, and it was a lot of the families within the music programs. But as the years are going on, we decided we wanted to reach out into the community more. Because it's such a rich culture in Upper Darby, and there's so many different cultures of music, we thought, well, wouldn't it be really cool to bring out all the different diversity in Upper Darby, and that way it's a bigger event, and it's more of a community event instead of just a school district event. So that's this year it became the Community Music Festival. There's a lot of excitement, and I have to say, Steve Bowman, who's the owner of 5 Points Coffee, which is down in the 69th Street area. He actually is a key player in putting all of this together.
We started 5 Points about 2 years ago. So we started in the beginning of the summer of 2013. So we came here to Upper Darby because of its diverse community to get involved and seeing how we could be a part of helping this community to grow. As a businessman, I was excited about setting up a cafe, which is a very social environment and a place where people could come together from a business standpoint, but also a community development standpoint. And also engage with the international student community here, just providing housing for them and services to international students, as well as the international community living here. So we really have a heart for this community, and it's just really exciting to see Jen's role in wanting to, you know, just enhance this community as well in the area of the arts. Obviously, Upper Darby High School is really a central focus, or the school district itself is a real central focus in this community. And so just being involved with her in the 5K run, and not only providing coffee, but just providing the relationships that we've been able to develop here in this community through our business and through doing community outreach. We've just been really excited to be a part of the whole process of that she's engaged with the music. Obviously, it's been an enhancement to our business as we get involved with other people, you know, getting just being there at the 5K run, being there at the music festival. We met a lot of people that we hadn't met before, and we also met a lot of people that were aware of our business that we hadn't known about. So it was a great opportunity for us to kind of show our heart to be involved in the community in this way, and also to really see our business enhanced and see more people in the community be aware of that we're here and what our kind of overall vision is, not just selling coffee, but being here to help improve the community.
Because as Five Points is right in the center of 69th Street area, and a lot of the local businesses are surrounding him. And he really helped me spread the word about the festival. And he introduced me to Christian Tizon, who also not only works for Five Points Coffee, but also has his own nonprofit. It's called Beat Peace, or Be At Peace.
Okay, I'm on the committee for the Brad Schoener 5K. And the music festival, they brought me on as a new addition. They wanted some new talent and new acts to be chosen, and they didn't know quite how to find new talent. And when they brought me on, I was able to bring that to the table. I started an organization here in Upper Darby called Beat Peace, Be At Peace. You throw it back together, it's Beat Peace. And Beat Peace Inc. pretty much really had the same goal as the Brad Schoener Fund does, which is collect instruments and provide instruments and lessons to those who can't afford it, especially gearing towards the youth. And when I heard that Jen Schoener was doing something very, very similar, I was really encouraged to meet her and really try to be under her and learn as much as I could from her so that I can apply that to my organization. When I do the open mics, we do the open mics once a month, and it really is a filter for me. I'm able to filter artists out, and when I throw my big showcases, I'm able to put some more of the talented artists, the ones that I see that can go a little bit further with their music, the ones that have more drive, to put them on a bigger showcase, like my showcases that I do at the end of the month, like the 5K Music Marathon. So it was very easy for me to pick and choose artists that I thought were quality enough to be on a bigger stage.
He was one of the key players because he actually booked one of our stages at the music festival himself with performers that he knew from the community. And that was fantastic because that really opened up a whole new group of people that we've never met and wouldn't have been able to meet if it weren't for Steve and Christian. They were fantastic in doing that. Dana Spino, who is our district liaison with the Upper Darby Arts and Education Foundation, she also is a very large player in what we call our music committee, or music selection committee for the music festival.
As a district liaison on the Arts and Education Foundation board, where Jen is an executive director, I know about all of the things and all the great work that the foundation is doing to try to benefit our kids. And there are certain committees then within that foundation that get formed, and I volunteered to help out with the 5K Marathon Committee. In my former life, in between my time in Upper Darby, I did own a bar and restaurant that supported local music, and so I befriended a lot of local musicians, some of which I think are as good as anybody that you hear on the radio. And so I was anxious to kind of share who I knew with Jen and see if she was interested in having any of them perform. This year, it turns out that we filled an entire stage of artists that used to play at my establishment. And some have direct connections to Upper Darby. Their kids went through here. Some have direct connections to education. You know, they're music teachers in other school districts or in private schools. Some have no connection to anybody here except for me, but obviously value music and what it's done for them, and wanted to make sure that they could do the same for any kids in our school district who might want to follow the same path. Upper Darby is a pretty unique community, and it is large, but it is very close-knit, and everybody is family. So I think my biggest connection is that I'm an educator in this district. I love kids. Everything I do is about the betterment of kids, and that was Brad's mission too. So I didn't need to know him to be able to feel connected to him. We share the same mission, as do all the teachers and educators in the school district. We do have a portion of our community that is in a low socioeconomic status, and they should have the same opportunities that everybody else might be able to afford. So knowing that I can do something that can help raise some money for those kids to get scholarships, for those kids to attend camp, for those kids to find their passions, it's a no-brainer, it's easy. You know, music really can shape the life of a child. And I just want to make sure that any child in this district has the opportunity to explore that if they want to.
Well, I think that's what the Schoener Festival is becoming. I think it's beginning to symbolize all of that passion and all of that community pride that there is in the arts program. It's not just music, it's the theater. The summer stage has been huge in Upper Darby. Tina Fey, a product of Upper Darby summer stage. There are a lot of big names that come out of Upper Darby that, you know, people may not even realize there's a connection there. But even the not just the performers on stage, but what happens behind the scenes. These kids are trained in lighting and sound, and then they go off and work in Hollywood or in New York. And you know, there's always somehow there's a Delaware County Upper Darby connection. And I think it's just grown and grown and grown, and people want it to stay that way, and they're very adamant that it should stay that way. That's why I kind of love working with the community there, because you always know exactly where you stand. Whether they like it or not, they will tell you right away, and that I love that because I know exactly, you know, where they're coming from, and that really helps you move forward with something.
I guess it was at one of the first Brad Schoener runs that I ran into Jen, just stopping in as a mayor, and she was very pleased to see me there, and I said, well, why don't you stop in, let's see what your program's doing. Obviously, Brad and Jen have a great love for Upper Darby, and when someone has a love for Upper Darby, you can see it shine through. And her particular, love for the music, but more importantly, love for her husband and fulfilling his goals for the children of Upper Darby, clearly was the message that I received that day. And a little bit of a fulfillment moment where you could tell there was emotion there. She wanted to fulfill Brad's last dream to do the band camp. And she was hitting, as every organization, financial hurdles, space, where do you have it? And she had the plan. And there's no question Jen has the merit all to put the plan together. But basically it was finances, if you really got down to it. It was finances and the school district willingness to open up a building, because it takes janitors and staff and everything else. We met once or twice, wasn't hard. And I have a very large recreation program, and we have summer stage. I met with my CIO, my finance people, and we shifted around some dollars for her first year. And she came through with the Phillies Foundation, I believe it was. And the two of us, by doing that, put out the first one. Well, if you know Jen, it was a smash hit for the parents, but it was a smash hit for children who would probably never have an opportunity. The instruments are important and the music's important, but the collaboration of the people she brings to the table, the mentoring, and Jen herself, and the enthusiasm that's in the community, you can't match anywhere. So it's very easy when you have a successful program the next year, and we expanded it. And it's done well. But I think the ultimate goal is when you go there the last day and you get involved with the children, and the children hand you whatever instrument they're doing to be able to do the final song, and everybody in the group is working with the children and they're teaching us. It shows that little determination, little dedication, at the end of the day, they make every child participate in that performance. in that short period of time, it's probably, unfortunately, in some of those children's lives, the only thing they've ever committed to and fulfilled and are being recognized for, which is the most important thing to recognize children.
So for the staffing of the Schoener Music Man Camp, I was really excited when Mayor McCosey said, you know, let's move ahead with this. So he said, you're going to need a camp director. So the first person I thought of was Justin Heimbecker, because Justin was a student of Brad's years ago, and Brad always talked about Justin, and oh my gosh, Justin Heimbecker does this, he does that, he's the perfect person to organize things. So I called Justin, I'm like, Justin, you have to do this because you are the person that Brad would want in this spot. And Justin never sleeps, I don't think, ever. But he's the director of U.S. bands, and he travels all over the country setting up performances for bands across the country, and he and I have the same desire to bring, you know, as much music, but as many music experiences to kids as we possibly can.
My name is Justin Heimbecker. I serve as the director of the Schoener Music Man Camp here in Upper Darby at Beverly Hills Middle School. It's our third year with the camp. I've been the director. I've been fortunate to be in this role for each of the past 3 years as we sort of build it from scratch with Jen Schoener. And I'm actually an alumnus of the district, of this school, and Brad Schoener is the person who first put an instrument in my hands many years ago. So it's fantastic that I can come back and contribute to making sure that his legacy and the legacy of a great arts and music program continues to thrive in Upper Darby for years to come. Each morning we get together with the students, we have a little bit of a welcome meeting, and we try to address some of the concepts that we try to reinforce through practice, but we really kind of take it outside the realm of playing musical instruments. For example, every morning we get into a circle and we play this silly little game where they have to slap each other's hands as fast as possible to get around the circle. And through repetition, through focused repetition, through trying to learn from mistakes and try to make small improvements, incremental improvements, we talk through exactly how that applies and transfers to musical practice or to sports practice or academics or really anything in life that you're trying to improve, hoping that the students will really catch on that there are certain things that go along with work ethic and repetition that they can take with them in life.
So I gave him a call and he said yes immediately, and it was just perfect, because what he managed to do was he brought on board a lot of not only the Upper Darby music teachers, but he also was able to bring in a lot of the Upper Darby high school students and alumni. So a lot of the kids that are our counselors, so to speak, on our staff, they have been through the whole Upper Darby routine, and they are teaching the younger ones, you know, what they have learned. And many of them are still former students of Brad's. And they actually have more Brad experiences than I do because they've worked with him in the classroom. And they, you know, have those memories that they can pass on.
Hey, I'm Emmanuel Wilkins. I play the alto saxophone. I go to Upper Darby High School. I'm a senior there. I'll be attending the Juilliard School in the fall. And I've been a student of Brad Schoener's for a while. Matter of fact, ever since third grade until his passing, you know, he was always a big influence on me. And he's taught me a lot about my life. And it was also great. You know, he always was. He was always good for getting everyone together and playing good music. And that's what I'm about. And he's instilled that in me. So
we have kids that were probably maybe in that band camp have now gone into the school, are now performing.
The Schoener Music Man Camp is for fourth graders through eighth graders who are interested in either a band or a string instrument. There are scholarships available. The student has to be a member of the Upper Darby School District, and they have to be recommended by a music teacher to receive a scholarship. We give out half scholarships and full scholarships. But the camp itself is open to anyone in Delaware County. The community itself is extremely passionate about their community, which I don't see in other places as much. I mean, there's an Upper Darby pride that's kind of a motto, but it's there, it's palpable, but it's not something that I can explain. Because Brad used to come home and he used to say, you know, you really should work in Upper Darby because there's another place like it. I would say, sure, hon, that's really nice, and you know. But he's right, but I can't put my finger on it. Since the Schoener Fund was started in 2009, this will actually be our seventh year coming up. since Brad created it, we've been able to give out at least $50,000 in lesson scholarships to kids and grants to the classroom music teachers. And also, we've been very fortunate. We have a donor that we just found by accident, believe it or not, because I was wearing my Schoener Music Man Camp shirt at the right time in the right place. But we'd had instrument donations of over $25,000 since last August. And word is spreading, which makes it, I'm just so excited because every year just something new happens and I never know where it's going to come from or from who, but people really, really care about putting music in the hands of kids. And that's why this is so rewarding for me.